Hello, I'm Sam Aldar, and in this video we'll be looking at Altium's mix simulation capability. Altium has a fully featured spice simulator which you could use to simulate and optimize your design. You could perform basic analysis such as DC sweeps, transients, and AC analysis, and you could perform a bit more advanced analysis such as FFT, stress, temperature sweeps, Monte Carlo, and sensitivity. I'll be demonstrating in this video a few tips and tricks that I've learned along the way, more specifically how I designed the simple 5-watt wireless charging circuit and how I use Altium's mix simulation capability to, first of all, simulate this design, understand how it works, and see where, in which areas it needs improving and optimizing it to get the best performance. So I'll show you first what is it we will actually be building. This is my design. It's a very simple and basic wireless charging circuit. It consists of a half bridge, which generates a square wave that goes into a transmitting coil that's tuned at resonance. And then we have a secondary resonant coil, and those two coils are inductively coupled. Then we have a rectifier, and finally we have our load. So let's start by creating this design from scratch. Okay, so I've got a brand new project with an empty sheet, and so let's start adding components to this. Now, if you're using Altium's mix simulation tool for the first time and you have your own library of components, most likely you don't have any spice models included with your components. Altium does come with a library, a spice library of components called simulation generic components. Now, if you don't see this library available to you, just go under your preferences, under simulation general, and make sure you've enabled this to see this library. So let's first of all begin by adding sources. And if you search voltage here, you have a bunch of sources you could use. However, I actually prefer to place my sources using this option here, top bar. If you click on it and select voltage source, and the reason being is that you can change this stimulus type, but also you get this nice preview of what your waveform might look like. So that's how I always add my sources. Okay, so I've got a basic schematic here. It just shows the theoretical operation of my circuit. So I'm using ideal switches to represent the half bridge, and they're both driven by pulses. Those two pulses are 180 degrees out of phase, and in each pulse you can specify parameters, the frequency, and the pulse width duration or duty cycle and rise and fall times. And you also have a preview here. So this is my lower pulse that drives the lower switch, and this is the upper pulse that drives the high switch, and you can see the difference here. This one is out of phase, so it starts at zero, whereas this one starts at 5 volts here. I've also got my transmitting and receiving coil inductances here, and the capacitors are chosen such that they resonate with this coil inductance, that's 6.78 megahertz. And I'd like to point out that I'm using an external resistor here to represent the loss in the inductor. I'm assuming a simple model where we have a equivalent series resistance. Now you can either use an external resistor, or you can, for every inductor, you can specify R series and R parallel. So it depends on which way you'd like to visualize the loss. So you can either say you've got your loss here, which is 0.2 ohms, or you could just use an external resistor. I prefer to use an external resistor. Now, on the receiver side, we've got our load. For now, this is going to be an AC voltage output, just to test that our circuit is working. One thing we need to do is tell Altium that those two inductors, LTX and RX, are actually coupled. And to do that, we need to add in a mutual inductance component. So if you just search for mutual, and you find the mutual inductance, and now we need to edit this component and select the inductances that are coupled. So if you click on it, and you'll notice here in the parameter section, you've got a coupling factor and the inductance list. So inductance list are the inductors that we want to couple, and so we have LTX and LRX. So let's add that. And the coupling factor is, well, depends on our physical implementation, but for now let's say it's 0.5. And so now we have told Altium that those two are coupled. So now if we run our simulation using transient analysis, as you can see here on the right, I've set up my start and stop time and the time step. I've also enabled output expressions. I want to see the switching node, the voltage across the load resistance, which is going to be AC voltage, and the current into the transmitting coil. So let's run this and we get our results. All of them are in three separate graphs, and you can zoom in one of them here. And I noticed, so we can see that we've got a voltage that is developing across the load resistance. Perhaps it might not be enough, but at least we know now that our simulation is set up correctly. We have current in the transmitting coil too. So everything seems to be theoretically working. We need to now do some optimizations and sweeps to improve the voltages here. One thing I'd like to point out while we're here at the graph is that I would recommend you enable a certain toolbar, specifically the SimView standard. This allows you to reset your zoom and zoom in and zoom out. Also, if you notice that if I zoom in only one of the graphs, it only zooms in this area here. It doesn't zoom in into the other areas, other plots. And to change that, you could just simply right-click anywhere and outside the graphs and go to document options. And if you uncheck zoom plots separately, so now if you zoom in one of them, all the other plots also zoom, and then you're at the right time point when you're viewing this graph. And this is the end of the first video. In the next video, we'll be looking at doing other types of analysis and how to use SPICE commands and directives.